ice looks exactly how it looks out there. It looks like something we've driven.
Hi, I'm Todd Dewey.
And I'm Lisa Kelly. We're Ice Road Truckers. Today we're going to be reacting to scenes from the new Netflix film, The Ice Road.
Didn't old timers back in the 60s drive the lake into April?
Yeah, and most of them died doing it.
That is exactly the truth. By the time April comes around, the water could be a foot to 2 feet deep on top of the ice. You don't even see the ice. We've had to do it several times to get someone their supplies because it's something I have never gotten comfortable with.
Is it really that dangerous?
We almost have the same look in our eye when she looked over him like, absolutely, this is dangerous.
You go too fast, you create a pressure wave. You go too slow and the ice can't handle the pounds per square inch on your tire. In you go.
She's right. You can't go too fast and you can't stop with the engine idling because the engine idling is what's shaking and weakening the ice.
There is a thing called pressure waves and it is created with more than one truck on the ice, especially when another truck is coming at you and those two waves hit at the same time. Boom. On the beginning of this movie, they set a 200-foot spacing between trucks. In real life, that is nowhere near enough spacing on the ice. It's way farther distance than that. There has been issues where trucks have broke down out in the middle of an ice crossing. So we'll have like 600-foot ropes, 700-foot ropes, so you actually connect and get way out in front of them really slow, get the rope tight, and then just start dragging them. At least get them off that lake and get their life out of danger.
I've sunk through on some soft ice, but it was like there was ice and then there was water and then it froze over the top. So when it first fell, it was really scary, but it was just on the first layer.
Let's figure this out.
I actually really like the idea that they have. I don't usually have an ice auger with me, but some of the truckers do because we like to test the ice for ourselves. So if you happen to have pipe like that and can put it in, that's a good idea. I think what I would have done differently is not unhooked the trailer from the truck. Because the truck's not in that far and all your weight's on the trailer. If you're pulling the trailer, you're gonna rip that landing gear off, then you're never gonna get hooked back up again. Maybe there's an idea behind that of getting the weight off the truck to pull it out, but it's not in that far. So it's only in a little bit. You can save that. He can do it. He's Liam Neeson, he can do it.
That's being an ice road trucker.
But hopefully my everyday life isn't quite that exciting, but some days it can be.
That was amazing. Had an absolute blast.
And don't forget to watch The Ice Road only on Netflix.